It's the Ron and Fez Show, live on 106.7 WJFK. We're Ron Bennington and Fez Whatley with you tonight, live on a Tuesday.
Fez, you got some nice comic books there, huh?
Yeah, buddy Laszlo stopped by during the commercial break, so I got a bunch of X-Men, I got some Avengers, some old comics, Daredevil, weird tales of war. Very cool. Look, Ronnie, the skeletons are actually fighting each other.
Well, that'll really keep you busy on a rainy day.
I got the Flash here, and I got the Hulk versus Wolverine. So that's very cool. By Todd McFarlane. Nice. So thank you very much, Laszlo. I appreciate that. Now, Ronnie, I messed up my ear today.
Your ear?
My ear, not my rear.
Actually, Fuzzy, how long have I told you to be careful over putting things in your ear?
I always stick stuff in my ear because they get itchy. I had a wooden stick Q-tip in there today. And you always told me not to go in too far. You're not supposed to put it in the actual canal. Just do the outside. I bump my arm and I jam this effing wood stick into my ear. And, man, I saw stars. It hurt that bad.
Now, I'm worried that you hit something really important down there.
I think I did, because now I can feel it. Like, if I swallow, I can feel the pain in my ear. It's still sore in there.
Yeah, you know what? You shouldn't even fool around with that.
I mean,
it sounds like you need to go to a doctor.
So, I mean, the initial pain went away, but now I started feeling it later on. I definitely bruised, bumped, or did something, cut something in there.
There's only one thing, eardrum. And that's important stuff.
Yeah, definitely.
Now, what, please, from this point on, that you just gently, and you don't do it more than a couple times a week, Q-tip your ears.
Oh, God. I do it probably 4 or 5 times a day.
See, that's like an OCD. That's an obsessive, crazy OCD.
I'm constantly digging into my ears.
I wish the Horde King was on right now, and I'd have him explain that to you, that you're insane. But now, I'm honestly concerned.
Yeah, after years and years of doing this, I think this is the first time I've actually done damage.
I always told you it was going to happen. I always told you.
You did, and you were right. Today was the day. Today was the day it happened. Maybe if I just don't move around while I'm doing it.
You know what? I'm glad that you're joking about it, but guess what? When you end up some crazy old man like Pete Townsend with no hearing, you're going to cry. God, I just did my mom's line. You're going to cry. You're going to cry. That'll be the day you cry. But I'm serious. It makes me nervous.
I know, but I don't know if I can help myself. It's the first thing I do in the morning is grab a Q-tip. It's the first thing. It starts digging around in my ear.
They say it's not that you have to keep some amount of wax in there because it's nature's way of keeping you safe.
Ah, it just seems so uncomfortable and itchy.
It's just like, you know how with a monkey they can't brush their teeth?
No, I didn't know that.
You can't brush a monkey's teeth.
Why?
They need that film over their teeth.
Ew.
They're monkeys. No, you don't say ew.
I know.
A horse has it, too.
Ew.
Everything has it.
Ew. And why don't we need it? Why isn't it better for us not to brush our teeth?
I don't know. That part I never heard about. But I always would go, why don't monkeys, somebody go in there and brush their teeth?
The only person I know that's done that is Paul Lowe, our movie reviewer.
Yeah.
He used to say he had a protective film over his teeth.
That's what it is. That's what they call it with the monkeys, a protective film.
And it was a nice orangish green, and he didn't want to, you know, break through the protective barrier with a toothbrush.
Can you hear everything perfectly?
Yeah, I can hear. I heard that.
Well, what did you hear?
I heard the word faggot.
I think you're just fine, because I barely said that.
I heard it. I have headphones
on. You know, it's funny. I've never heard you say that word before.
No, I don't know if I ever have.
I saw you kind of wince.
Faggot. I got to isolate.
Yeah. Yes.
Do not isolate things.
He can't hear you. He's got a protective film.
Over his eardrums. Now, have you ever done something to yourself where you did it to the point of injury? Like just scratched yourself till you drew blood? Or one of those people that bite their nails down to the nub?
Oh, you know what it was when I used to do speed when I was younger?
Yeah.
I might end up chewing on the inside of my mouth or on my lip.
Ooh.
And do something horrible. Or bite on my thumbs a little bit. And then one time I was all I was so high on speed, and I was like clamming, and I was getting oysters, and then I went back and cleaned the oysters, and I just had like a huge amount of them. And I was doing all these Christmas trees. I'm just speeding my ass off. And my parents are like, oh, how nice. He's really, you know, he won't give up. And I just shredded my fingers, man.
Oh,
shredded
man.
Them on oyster shells.
That is brutal.
Because I couldn't stop once I started. I was like you with your skank ears.
I don't have skank ears, trust me. I have the cleanest injured ears around. Because I'm constantly digging into them. See, that always fascinates me when someone does something to themselves to the point of abuse.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, like people who really ruin their fingers.
Yeah, I mean, there's a buddy of ours, Al Dukes. Al Dukes would chew the skin off the sides of his fingernail.
Yeah.
And he was constantly holding a paper towel that was all bloody. Because he would bloody his fingers every night.
And the reason why is he always wished that was a D in his mouth. That was my belief.
The thumb seems the most D-ish.
Hefe, you,
I got a real bad one right now, and I'm trying to break myself of it. With these dreadlocks, my hair itches all the time.
Yeah.
And so I'm constantly picking at my scalp, like, to the point where it's bloody. And then, like, the fun of it is the next day when it's crusted over so I can pick at it again.
Oh, God. It's so gross.
I mean, you know, I've caught myself, like, my dreadlocks were even starting to come out a little bit on the side, if you notice.
Yeah.
Because I picked so much, and it's just on my left side.
Yeah, you think it's a nervous thing?
No, it's a boredom thing, because I usually find myself doing it on the drive to and from home.
Yeah.
And it's real, and it's so embarrassing, because then you have little white things all over your dreadlocks, and you look at Hefe, he's a dirty bastard.
Right.
Yeah.
Come on. Hey, Pezzy, one of the things about earwax, it's a bug repellent. And if he digs it all away, the centipedes will lay eggs in his brain while he sleeps.
Oh, no. There's not a centipede that's going to get in my ear.
Well, that's what they say.
Who's they? Why are they the experts? And I'd love to know why...
Oh, Pantera wrote in that he also chews the skin around his fingertips. That's so gross.
See, now that's weird. Now me, I'm digging my eardrums out, but yet to me, the chewing on the finger skin seems
weird. Here's the difference, though. The eardrum thing is really scary and dangerous.
Yeah, like, nobody goes deaf from biting their fingers.
Right. And I've always been worried about you. Because obviously, Fez, this is... It's a little bit scary that you're into this eared thing so heavy.
It just really, really feels good. Not
I
when
know.
You jab it. But...
Yeah. But, I mean, it's almost like being a cutter. Hi, you're on the Ron Fez Show. Who's this?
Teresa.
Hi, Teresa. What can we do for you?
I bite my knuckles, so can I bleed?
Really?
Really?
You yeah. Wouldn't rather have a big thick D then?
What?
Nothing.
I can hear you.
I was saying you wouldn't rather have a big thick D.
Yeah.
What? Now, how often do you do this?
Every day. I'll show you next time I see you.
Yeah, great.
Show me the girl with the knuckles.
Can I tell you something? You'll be knuckles down when I see you, honey.
No, I'm kidding.
So you don't bite your nails, just your knuckles?
My nails are fine. It's my knuckles and my cuticles, and they're really, really bad. Like my kids to the point where, get your hands out of your mouth. Everybody always told me, get your hands out of your mouth.
Were you a thumb sucker? Were you a thumb sucker?
No, never. Mm-mm.
And it's just right on the knuckles.
Yeah, my knuckles are like around, you know, like when you bend your fingers, that little line?
Yeah.
I bite that too.
All right, so is it all 10?
Yeah, it's like my fingers are swollen. Wow. But I just keep doing it, and everybody's like, oh, we'll put stuff on your fingers. I was like, no, I'll probably like the way it tastes. Like, you know that bitter stuff they have for, like, nail biters?
Yeah, sure. Like, the last thing you want to start doing is putting hot sauce on there and making it even better.
Just pouring hot sauce in the open
making
wound.
It tasty.
Yeah, I think I was eating chicken fingers.
Literally.
When don't you?
Mm-hmm.
If it was up to me, your knuckles would be scraped, and so would your forehead and kneecaps.
Yeah. That'd be fun.
Matt, you need that.
You need that, don't you?
Yeah.
All right, honey.
All right, thank you. Talk to you.
That took a weird turn.
Get her a number.
Of course, get a number.
I love to hear these stories about people that are going to abuse themselves. My brother Corky, man, he will sit there, pick the skin off his feet, and eat it.
Oh, man, that's it.
Where are you going?
I quit.
You can't quit.
Because you come from a skank family, and I can't work like this.
Why am I a skank family person?
You don't eat dead skin unless there's something psychologically wrong with you.
He always did that. He was always biting off his own toe skin.
I'm so grossed out by that.
He would put his foot up to his mouth and do it, or would he pick it and then put it in?
Both. He would actually do both. He could bite his own toes. Oh. The boy has talent.
Oh, so gross.
Not to mention the fact that he's walking around in those cowboy boots all day.
Even just people that bite on their fingertips. Didn't Rory always used to do that?
Yeah.
Did I always see him?
Fingertip biter.
I almost completely forgot about him.
Who?
Yes. Rory. Everyone remembers Rory. Was Rory the alcoholic that was stapled?
No, that's Billy.
Is he the one with the daughter?
Rory's from Armenia, right?
No, that's Harry.
I can't remember Rory too much.
Rory Hampton's. Rory Hampton's finger biter. Which Rory, I believe is his full name.
Rory Hampton Spotley.
Oh, quit laughing on that thing. Why don't you go fix your head, Scabs?
Aww. You leave, Scabby. You know what? I'm noticing this. I think El Hefty's finding me a little funnier than you for a change. I think instead of having Rory and Mikey D, who basically all but coronate you queen of the show, I got El Hefty and T. Krebs.
It's J. Dubs.
Whatever. I'm saying I used to know a guy named T. Krebs. I'm bringing him up.
And it's Hefty, not Hefty.
Did I say Hefty? You know I'm tired.
You said it right.
Oh, God. Then don't do it to me when you know I'm bizarrely tired. All right, man. Well, that's weird, Fezzy, and I got to tell you the truth. I'm concerned about you.
Me too, because my ear still hurts. And now my scalp itches.
Have you called your doctor?
No, remember I had a falling out with my doctor?
Call him tomorrow, promise me.
I am not going to call that man. I broke up with him.
I still, you know what, but here's the thing, no matter what you do, make sure that you give him a buzz.
Well, I wrote him that letter and said that I wasn't coming back to him because the staff is rude to me. And now that figures, as soon as I write the letter, now I need a doctor. I should have seen that one coming.
Ain't that the way?
Yes, it is the way. I should have definitely seen that one coming.
I should have saw you coming.
Nah, you don't want to see that.
You get it. You know where I'm going.
I'm with you.
Always.
So,
no matter how many times I try to shake you, you're with me.
I know, but now I'm going to have to go crawling back to the guy because my ear really hurts.
You know, one time my little sister stuck a screw up her nose when she was little, like about 5 years old. I'll never forget it. And she had to go, and they had to pull it out with this long thing. And I'm like, what kind of idiot picks their nose so much, they shove a screw up it?
My niece one time shoved a Red Hot up her nose, which started to melt and wasn't a very pleasant feeling whatsoever.
Why do you always got to top me? Why is that your thing in life?
I'm adding to it. And my nephew, his thing was he always caught his finger in the can of Parmesan cheese in the green can.
Oh, for some reason, I thought you were talking about one of those scrapers, like you do on Parmesan cheese.
Oh, no.
What are those things called?
A grater.
A grater.
Yeah.
Man, I used to always want to use that like in a gladiator fight. And my mom would go, where are you going with that grater? She'd catch me trying to go outside with it.
Gladiator fight.
I was obsessed with graters, the cheese grater, when I was younger. Can you believe that in no movie has anyone ever used a cheese grater? Wouldn't that be great, like in a kung fu movie or something?
That would be great, the cheese grater just across the forehead or anywhere else. They use it on wrestling.
Yeah, try to get this on Paulo's new movie.
Paulo's new movie. That's never going to happen. He's never going to tell us what it's about. Unless it's cheese graters.
Yeah.
Cheese graters from space. I'm trying to think. I remember one time. Oh, God. I was 3 years old. We went to this, what they told us was a fancy restaurant. And they had big room dividers up in the buffet.
Yeah.
And those things, they would fold up on the hinges. And you stretch them out like a little fake wall.
Wow.
And when I was a kid, I got my finger caught in between the two of them.
Mm-hmm.
It's pinching my finger off. I start freaking out. I knock the whole room divider off over onto the buffet table.
What an idiot. What an
and idiot. I was just screaming, and my finger was still stuck. The thing went over. The food is all spilt, and I am just sitting there screaming. Does anybody watch me?
Yeah.
I was on my own at that point. That one's making sure the baby isn't getting into trouble.
Sure. There's always something. That's literally always something, Fez. J-Dubs!
Hey, J-Dubs.
How's it going?
What can we do for you, brother, man?
I don't know if this is a nervous habit or what, but whenever I am writing a movie or looking for CDs in a store, I fart a whole lot.
You know what's really weird? You know what's really weird?
What's that?
I saw that post by our buddy Bobby Bantera, who says he does the same exact thing.
Are you serious?
Yes.
I thought I was the only one.
No. I think he's even online tonight. I wouldn't mind getting a hold of him. Because when I read that, I go, is he trying to be funny?
It's serious. I don't know why.
All right, explain the phenomena again.
I'm looking for a movie, and I always have to rush through the line because I just let a few go.
Yeah.
And, like, there's people behind me and everything, so I want them to think that someone else, so I just rush.
So you try to do it silently?
Yeah, I try to do it silently.
Does it happen when you're looking through anything?
Yeah, like, looking through almost anything, like, but it mostly happens in CD stores and movie rental places.
That is
weird. He brought up the same thing. He said it was a Blockbuster.
Yeah, usually a Blockbuster or Best Buy or something like that.
It makes you have to go to the bathroom.
Yeah.
Not so much the bathroom, you just get gas, right?
Yeah, I just get really gassy.
But never to the point where you have to run out and find a bathroom.
No.
Okay.
Now, I wonder if it's a... I wonder if it's a thing of you worry that you'll do it, so then you do it. You know what I'm saying? Like, you worry about yourself in social situations, so then you do it.
No, I really don't care about that. I don't really care if I fart in public or anything. It just happens.
Sure.
Then.
But you go out of your way not to really rip one.
Yeah.
So you do care on some level. And you know you're not normal.
Yeah.
That's...
Maybe you're just really into movies. And you're so relaxed there.
No, do you think you're relaxed or nervous?
I'm probably really relaxed.
Yeah.
It's usually when I'm renting movies like Waiting to Exhale and stuff like that.
Yeah, the rest of the crowd is, too.
I get it.
The rest of the customers.
What's the local number here so we can put Bobby on? Because he has the same thing.
Okay, it's 202-432-1067.
1067. I never use that one. I always go
like the radio station.
I always go the other direction. I'm going to get him to call in. Because that's weird that I saw his post on RonFez.net, which, by the way, is down for some reason. And it's the same exact thing. I mean, literally the same exact thing.
I didn't think that would be that normal.
You know? No, me neither. When I saw it, I wondered if this is going to be him right here, Fezzy, so I won't even go. Yeah, I'll just take him.
So that's Pantera calling in.
Yeah, Hefe. Take your thumb off. Hey, Bobby.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey, Pantera.
Hey, what's up, guys? Haven't heard from you in a while.
Yeah. You heard this story, right?
Yeah.
Is it the same exact thing you do?
Everywhere. It's not only at the video store. I mean, I could be in, like, a department store, anything.
So it's anytime, like, you're shopping.
I don't know what
that
it is.
That there's people in a crowd.
Every single time I'm shopping. I mean, there's not one time I can remember. Not
ever?
Even, like, Blockbuster and having to fart a couple times.
So when you're looking for stuff, for some reason...
Yeah, and
your
and
bowel wants to pop.
Three out of aisles sometimes because I don't want people to, because I see someone coming down, you know. But I pretty much mastered a way to, like, get it out with knowing when I could get around people, you know. I like, as I'm going around someone, because if they think there's someone behind them while I'm going down the block, you know, like down the aisle.
Yeah, we'll get together. We'll compare notes on this.
What do you think? It is a weird thing.
Do you think it could be like the like in a video store, a CD store? There's so many aisles where you're going up and down. Do you think it's those little walls there? Do you think it's the security of being there makes you relax enough to pass gas?
Honestly, Fez, I wish I knew where, because I'll stand there and I'll go, I know this is happening, and I'll look around. I'll be like, I can't do it. Where I have to like start running. I've ran out of stores before.
You look like a shoplifter. And then you're going to have to explain that it's gas.
I hold up my hands. I've done this plenty of times. I hold up my hands like I have nothing while I'm running out of the store.
I'm clean. Except for my shorts. I'm clean.
It's so funny. I don't know.
That is bizarre.
All right, let me ask. Pantera, let me ask you this and ask J-Dubs this. If you get this feeling while you're like looking through the videos and the DVDs, when you leave the store, does the feeling pass, or do you still have the gassy feeling once you're done with that chore?
Like on the ride home?
Yeah.
No. Once I'm out, you get one good one on the way out, and you're done. I'm serious. I can't even explain it. You waiting online is the worst. If there's a long line, I won't buy anything.
Yeah.
I don't know. Even if I'm online, I'll feel it. I'll be like, oh, no. I can't wait there.
Oh, no.
Yeah, seriously.
What about you, J-Dubs? Yeah. Is the feeling passed?
After I leave, it's totally gone. Yeah.
All right, I think, and here's my, you know, as a psychologist, and I, you know, did 8 years of psychology.
When?
Well, I was planning on it.
Oh.
But, I mean, I was a shop major in high school. So, you know, I made an end table once. I honestly think that the thing here is you guys have some kind of a crowd thing, almost, I wouldn't even say phobic, but somewhere along there that you, instead of having like a panic attack or something, it has a physical thing in their body. And they get gassy. It's a little bit of nerves.
It might be.
Like my stomach acid start moving?
Yeah.
That could be.
Maybe you don't like crowds that much.
No, actually, I really do hate crowds. It's very true.
I don't mind crowds. It's just entertainment places where I'm going to buy entertainment.
He can't stand entertainment places.
So this is not going to happen if you try to go buy pants or sneakers.
No.
Ew.
Just movies or CDs.
No, I'll get it in the dressing rooms. I'm not.
Well, you don't care.
Everywhere. I don't understand it. It's very strange.
Do you get it in the grocery store?
Yes. In delis? I'll have to.
They're now called smellies.
For my sandwich. Honestly, it happens to me everywhere.
That sandwich is to go, please.
Yeah, I think yours is probably a little bit more psychological. And probably they're both psychological. Worse things could happen and get a little gassy.
You guys get it at work?
No, not at work. I don't get it at work. I don't get it at home as much as I do when I'm shopping. I really have no idea what that is.
You dislike shopping?
I hate department stores.
Yeah.
I hate crowds, you know?
Yeah.
I hate people standing behind me. I hate all that.
Yeah, so imagine how the people feel.
You know what I think I would do with him if I was his doctor is bury him alive for a half an hour.
That's what you would do?
Mm-hmm.
Just so he gets used to a crowded feeling?
Yeah.
No, thank you.
Boy, you must be murder when it's time to go Christmas shopping.
No, I can't do it. I can't do it. That's the worst. That's my worst fear. That would be my personal health.
What about when you shop online?
See, that's where you got to win. You don't shop online. You don't have any lines. You don't have any pressure.
No pressure on you. All you're doing is picking out a DVD, for heaven's sake.
You know what? I put more pressure on myself there than I do buying a house. I will look harder.
You hate to get a bad movie.
I go, I don't know. I just, I'm at a point right now. I don't know about this road to perdition. And I'm just walking back and forth with going, I don't know. Let me go see. It just annoys me. It's foreign. I don't know.
Well, at least you're keeping your gas to yourself.
Well, do you ever do this when you go there and you're in a good mood, and then you see, like, there's 800 of the same movie already rented and not one for you?
Yeah, that's a pain in the ass.
I might as well take a gun and kill myself.
Don't do that.
Or fart up the aisles like these two losers.
I can hear you.
Oh, I didn't know that. I thought for sure you had hung up. I thought that was weird that when you brought that up, I had seen his post before.
Yeah, so I didn't think anybody read that stuff.
El Jefe, do you have this problem? the shopping gases?
No, I've done it before, but it's not something usually that I'll do. I do like farting on my friends, though.
See, that's just, that's
people are so gross.
And I hope you get adopted. You know what? I'm going to take that and I'm going to give it to the adoption agency. And I'm going to say not even a little African kid with monkeypox should have to put up with that.
If they get farted on.
One quick rule. Dubs is right now living with me until he gets his place. And whenever I get back to the apartment, he's sleeping.
Yeah.
And I'll let one fly in his face while he's sleeping. And he is a girlfriend and I get a nice giggle out of
okay.
it.
Okay.
All right, so your chick, you know, like two couples living there?
Yeah, right now.
God, what a tweaker pad that is. What a tweaker pad. All right, we got to take a break. Bobby P., nice talking to you. How's Lisa, man?
She's doing good.
All right, give us our love from us, okay?
Will.
Thanks, right. Pantera.
All right, see you later, Bobby Pantera. Take a quick break, come back and end the show. Run fast.